Okay, so dear students, now we are on question number 8 from exercise 3.2. 3.2 question number 8 says, which of the following numbers are prime? Beta, remember, in your book, there are only 4 questions. In your book, there are only 4 questions related to it, but I am including some more into it. I am including some more into it, which is not in NCERT. They are from R.S. Agarwal. So please do it, those questions in your fair copy. So aapko ye pure note karne hai beta. It is asking which number is a prime number. So the first one is 23. Second one is 51. Third one is 37. Fourth one is 26. Now, beta, these questions are from NCERT only, but I am giving you some more. Okay? So now I am giving you some more from here. Question number E, 31. Question number F, 53. Question number G, 15. Question number H, 9. And question number I, 99. These are the questions from my side also. Okay? Now think one by one and write it down in front of the numbers only which are prime. And if they are composite, write it down C in front of them. Now remember, beta, what are prime number? Prime numbers are the numbers which are having only 2 factors. The first one is 1 and another one is the number itself. Okay? So let us see one by one which numbers are prime. Yes, Avantika, your answer is right. And before you, somebody else is also given 23 and 37. Let us try now this. 23, yes, it is a prime number. Absolutely right. 51 is not a prime number, beta. 51 is coming into table of 3 also, and also in the table of 17. Okay, 17 threes are 51. So remember, this is not a prime number, it is a composite number. So I'm going to write C in front of that number. Now let's move on to the next number, that is C, 37. Yes, 37 is a prime number. Now let's move on to the next number, 26. Beta, 26 is coming in table of 2 also because it is an even number, and also in the table of 13. So this number is not a prime number. It is a composite number. So I have written it C in front of that number. Okay? Now let's move on to E. E is 31. 31 which I gave you extra, beta. 31 is a number which is a prime number. So I am writing it over here P. P for prime. Now F. 53. 53 is also a prime number only. So I am also writing again P only. Now let's move on to 15. Beta, many students become confused in 15. But remember, beta, 15 is not a prime number. 15 is a composite number. Remember, because 15 comes in table of 3 also, 5 also, and 15 also. So remember, 15 is not a prime number, it is a composite number. So I will write it down C in front of it. And the last one is 9. Again, beta, this is again a question where students become very much confused. 9 is not a number which is a prime. It is a composite number, beta. It comes in table of 1. It comes in table of 3. It also comes in table of 9. So remember, this is also a composite number. So I'll write it down C in front of this number. Dear students, I forgot I, that was 99, and 99 is a number which comes in table of 3, which comes in table of 33, and which also comes in table of 11 also, 9 also. So remember, this is a number which is a composite number. So I will write it down C over there. Okay? So, beta, question number 9 is asking from us that write 7 consecutive composite number. Consecutive ka matlab hota hai, beta, the numbers without any gap. Theek hai, ek saath pure number likh de, और उसमें कोई गैप नहीं आना चाहिए, ठीक है? So question number 9 में you have to write all the number which should be consecutive. तो consecutive बेटा याद रखिएगा 90 से शुरू होते हैं बेटा, हाँ 90 is a composite number, 91 is a composite number, 92 even and composite also, 93 divisible by 3, 94 even number, it is again a composite number, 95 comes in table of 13, composite number, 96 is even number, so it is again composite number. So remember, these are all seven number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and remember these are all composite number. No prime number comes in between. No prime number comes in between these seven numbers. Now students, if I talk about question number 10, it is telling here, express each of the following numbers as the sum of three odd prime. Beta, remember odd prime ka matlab hota hai, the number should be odd also. Odd ka matlab hota hai 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, like this. But remember, question says that you have to take odd number also and prime number also. And remember, except 2, all the numbers are odd prime. For example, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37. These all are, abhi line bahut lambi hai beta, na? I have written only few. So these are all odd prime number. Ye sare odd prime number kehlate hain beta, theek hai? Now the question is asking from us, you have to write 21 in such a way that you have to write it down ki hum teen number, aise kaun se teen number hai jinko hum add kare to hame 21 milna chahiye, और तीनों के तीनों बेटा नंबर जो होने चाहिए वो ऑड प्राइम होने चाहिए. प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस. सी, आपको 21 को ऐसे ब्रेक करना है कि वो तीन नंबर्स में ब्रेक होना चाहिए, पहली कंडीशन. सेकंड कंडीशन, ब्रेक करने के बाद केवल एडिशन में आपको ब्रेक करना है. थर्ड कंडीशन, दैट ऑल द नंबर शुड बी ऑड प्राइम, ऑल द नंबर शुड बी ऑड प्राइम. नाउ थिंक एंड रिप्लाई. Very good. I am getting the reply 13, 3, 5. Somebody has written this answer to me and absolutely correct. 13 and 3 hota hai 16 and 16 and 5 hota hai 21 and all three are odd prime. Absolutely correct answer, beta. Very correct. Now the next number was 31. The next number which I gave you was 31. And somebody has written the answer right now, and that is absolutely correct answer. 23 is a odd prime number, 5 is also a prime number, and 3 is also a prime number. So 23 and 5 hota hai 28, and 28 or 3 ko jab hum add karte hai, maybe you will get it 31. So this answer is also absolutely correct. Very correct, beta. Yes. So beta, next number was 53, which I have written 43 plus 7 plus 3, and all together when you will add, it will give you 53. And remember, all are odd prime numbers. All are odd prime numbers. Okay. Now next number is 61. Next number is 61. Now let's see 61. Now, beta, remember, you have to think always the number in such a way that they should all odd prime. They should have all odd prime numbers. And remember, 2 ke alawa, beta, sare odd prime hote hain. Theek hai? Jitne bhi prime number hote hain, keval 2 ko chhod karke, baaki sare odd hote hain. Theek hai? So remember, you should not be having any confusion regarding it. It will be easier to solve it. Yes. So the next question is question number 11, and in question number 11 it says that you have to write the pairs. Pair ka matlab hota hai beta, keval 2 numbers, hai na? So you have to write five pairs in such a way that they should be only prime number. वो number केवल prime होने चाहिए. तो for example 3 and 7 देखो दोनों prime है. दोनों को जब हम add करते हैं हमको मिलता है 10 और 10 जो है वो 5 के table में आता है. So like this only you have to think more numbers. ठीक है. Now I am talking about another number 2 and 3. 2 and 3 both are prime number. Add करो तो आता है 5. And 5 is also coming in table of 5. So, ये भी सही हो गया. Now, next move on to 17 and 3. 17 or 3, both are prime numbers. 17 or 3 को add करो तो आता है 20. And which is also comes in the table of 5. So, this is again correct. Now, let us move on to the next number. That is 13 and 2. 13 or 2 को add करो तो आया 15. And you are knowing it is coming in the table of 5 again. Now let's move on to the next number. It can be now another number. Suppose I am taking this time 5 and 11. And 19. 11 and 19 ले लेते. तो 11 and 19 when you will take it, it will give you here 30. And 30 again, which is divisible by 5. It also comes in table of 5. Now finish. So question number 12 is fill in the blanks. And question number 12A is a number which has only two factors is called a. A. What a? A prime number. Very nice. Many students have given me the right answer. It's absolutely right. A number which is having only two factors is only called a prime number. Okay? Now let me tell you second one. A number which has more than two factors, जिसके एक factor नहीं होते, जिसके एक से ज्यादा factors होते हैं, तब हम क्या बोलते हैं उसको? Okay, very nice. Very good. It is called a composite number. C-O-M-P-O-S-I-T-E. Composite number. So the first one is a prime number, second one is a composite number. Now let's move on to the third one. One is neither blank nor blank, told by me many times, right? Very good. One is a number which is neither prime nor composite. Absolutely right, beta. And iska answer ye isliye aayega because prime number ki definition bolti hai ki aapko two factors chahiye, aur composite number ki definition kehti hai ki aapko more than two factors chahiye. लेकिन वन एक ऐसा यूनिक नंबर होता है जिसके पास केवल एक ही फैक्टर होता है. सो ये दोनों की टेबल पे सेटिस्फाई नहीं करता. इट इज नॉट कमिंग इन टेबल ऑफ एनी अदर नंबर. सो दैट इज व्हाई इट इज नीदर प्राइम एंड नॉर कंपोजिट. ठीक है. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट नंबर. द स्मॉलेस्ट प्राइम नंबर इज, ओ माई गॉड, मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर राइटिंग 3 ऑल्सो. स्मॉलेस्ट प्राइम नंबर आई एम आस्किंग माई डियर. स्मॉलेस्ट प्राइम नंबर. Very good. Smallest prime number is 2. Because 1 is neither prime nor composite. Or 1 ke baad turant aata hai kya? 2. And 2 is a prime number, beta. 2 is a prime number. Now tell me, smallest composite number. Ye bhi hum logo ne padha hai. Which is the smallest composite number? Smallest composite number. Very right. Very correct. It is 4. Smallest composite number. Composite number starts from 4 only. So composite number, smallest composite number is 4. Absolutely right. Now the last one is smallest even number. Can you tell me what is the smallest even number? Smallest even number. Very good. It's 2. Smallest even number is 2.